Hey guys, I'm Love and today I'm going to teach you C++ for loop again. Today in this for loop, I'm going to show you how to make designs using stars. So like we'll have a star design in this. So first let's open code blocks. So exactly what will happen is that first there'll be one star, then two stars, then three stars, then four stars, five stars, like that. So it's going to be a loop, and using a loop we'll make five, six stars, seven stars according to the number of rows. So first let's open the C++ project, and here we'll name it as I'm going to do ascending order and descending order of this star. So I'll do ascending order design. Okay, so that is it. Let's enter, let's start. So here we are going to first remove all this code, open the brackets. So we'll start off first with declaring three integers. One is int a, one is int b, and the third one is int rows. Int rows is the amount of rows you want the design to come in. So then after that we are going to do c out, enter number of rows. Wait, I forgot to put it in the new line. Okay, now let's do it. Now we'll do CIN, which is input rows. We are going to get the input of the number of rows which the user has given to us. So after that comes the for loop. So for brackets, A is equal to 1. This is our first statement. This is the predetermined beginning of this for loop. The end should be equal to or less than the number of rows which you have given in this sin, like these rows. It should be lesser than or equal to this number of rows. And here after this statement we are going to increment of the number of rows. It increases every single time. So now we are going to do after this is open the brackets for for loop, and we are going to enter another for loop here. So here it's going to be b is equal to 1. B should be always less than or equal to a, which also means that it should be lesser than rows. But then you can't declare the same thing two times, and we are going to do B++. Now we are going to enter another for loop brackets, and here we are going to do what is known as C out. We are going to enter stars. So let's put this, stars are entered, and now here inside this for loop, the first for loop, we are going to write C out end L. So that we end the line after every single time. Yeah, so now that this is done, now let's for always, we have to always end with return 0. So let's enter, let's go here. Return 0. So this is our program. So first we are declaring three integers, a, b and rows. Then we are going to see out, we are going to show as enter number of rows. We are going to get the input of the number of rows from the user. A, this we start a for loop in which first the beginning is that A is equal to 1. Then after that A should be less than equal to rows. And then increment A. A plus plus by 1 only. Then here for B is equal to 1. B is less than equal to A. And we are going to increment B. Then we are going to print this star. And we are going to after that end the line. So let's first build it. No errors. No, there is an error. There is. I accidentally put this semicolon. Okay, let's build it again. There's no error. So now let's run it. Enter number of rows 7. See, it has come. First 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7. And also one thing, if you want, you can do one thing, is that you can do this also. A plus 1 is equal to 3. And here also you have to do the same thing. So just build it. And now let's run it. Let's do 9. See, only 3 times it has come, because you have to. And if we do this, so that is what? So the number of times you increase it, the lesser the number of rows it will come. So it's best to just keep it like this. Let's build it. Let's try for a huge, big number like 25. See, it has all worked. Okay, so this is what I call as the ascending order design. Now let's close this program. And now I'm going to show you the descending order design, which is the more difficult one, because you have to do like it's very difficult. So first let's start. So we start off with, again we are going to do A, B and rows like always. So C++, here we are going to do descending order design. Yeah, so this is done. Descending order design is open. So first, like always, this is going to be almost exactly the same. So let me just remove this part, because we need the return 0. So first we'll start off with int A, B and rows, just like last time. Then here we are going to do C out, the same thing, C out, enter number of rows. This is done. After that we are going to get the input of number of rows, sin rows. After that we are going to start the for loop, and here we are going to do like A is equal to rows. Here it's ulta, here it's opposite, because we are doing decrement, decrement here. So A is equal to rows, it starts up with rows, then A should be greater than or equal to 1, because you are going down till 1, and you are going to do A minus minus. So this is the decrement. So we are decreasing it every single time. Let's open these brackets. And here we are going to have another for loop like last time, which is equal. But this one is going normal only, because this one is the loop in which you enter like the number of stars. It is like the, it should be B starts with 1, because this number of stars is always going to start with 1, and then B is less than equal to A. So here, because it has to be always equal with A, it comes like this. B is less than equal to A, and B increment. So the only difference here is that this increment sign becomes decrement, and this, these two positions change. Everything else is the same, but see, due to one change, how much difference there is. So here let's enter the statement, C out, And here also we are going to do just a star. And here let's write C out. And L. Yeah, and this is done. So it's exactly the same, but just that you just change this main thing. This entire increment decrement, the for loop of A is the only thing that changed in the entire both of these codes. See, there it was A is equal to 1 and A is less than equal to rows and A plus plus. Here it's A is equal to rows. A should be always greater than or equal to 1, and you're going to decrease it every single time. So now let's build it. It has worked. Let's try here 9 again. See, it's coming perfectly. And now let's try decrement of 3. Let's build it. Let's run it. 9. See, it's working. It comes 9. Let me see. 3, 6, 9. Then comes 6. Then comes 3. There it was showing like that because where it was increasing, here it's decreasing. Decreasing, it always, then it will always decrease by 3 only, because it's written this. So 9, then 6, then 3, then 0. Because there's no such thing as 0, so it's going to stay the same. So this is it for my video. I hope you liked it. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And bye.